Hey wavy babies, it's Ocean Sims. Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be taking a look into some super cool build and buy items that are basically like a must-have for me, or just in general, just something that I feel like is going to stay in my game for a while, and then a couple of new things that I found. Now I'm going to be honest, I have never done a build and buy CC haul type of thing because I've just never really been a fan of build CC, especially like when you start downloading custom content build items and buy items, you literally start going down a very deep dark hole. But these things that I've found today honestly just make everything a whole lot better in my opinion. Like I really love the things that I got. The first, starting with this really cute couch. I always feel like The Sims 4 needs some couches, but I really love this couch because it is so simple and it definitely looks maxis match, so it doesn't like stand out too much, and it just reminds me of just like a really simple couch that you'd see at your grandma's or something. And then we also have some pillows that go on it as well, and I also love the swatches that it comes in. Like look how cute that is. I love that. I don't normally go for like pillow accessories, that's just not my style, but I saw it and I thought, you know, it'd be nice to like just give it a try, and I kind of like that. I kind of like the vibe of that. And then here I have this little desk, and it's really cute. It reminds me of like that one desk that came with Tiny Living because it's just very like short and compact. I believe it's called the student desk, and I kind of really like that because, you know, say you don't really need like a really big desk, you just want a little nice space, okay, for your Sims. You put a little laptop up there, that's kind of cute. Then I have another desk here as well. I don't know, I kind of went crazy with the desk, maybe, I don't know. This is like a little wall organizer for my gamers out there. I actually should probably place this in here so that you can see it. I downloaded this set that was like totally for gamers, people that work in software or something like that. It's called a high-tech set, and I really love it as far as storytelling is concerned. So I placed these two desks together because, yeah, this is like the little wall organizer. We have a recording microphone, say you're starting a podcast or something. And then here we have this monitor. These are just decoration. But it's really cool though, because if you were to like storytell or whatever and you just need things like, you know, for a prop for your Sims, you could definitely do that with these, which I really love. I don't know. I just like the way that this looks. Then we also have some more uni books, some books for university. I'll just place these on top of here just so you can see them. I'm not someone that likes a lot of clutter and decor, but I feel like, you know, this just looks more realistic than the books that they give us, you know. I don't know, just adds a flair. Just adds a little flair. We also have a simple backpack for decoration as well. I kind of like this backpack because it's not like the kids one. Like anyone could probably wear this backpack. I love it. Comes in a ton of colors too. And then we also have the expensive microphone. I know it looks like I'm like going everywhere. So I showed you the like cheaper microphone, but this is the more expensive microphone. This kind of looks like my setup a little bit with my mic right here, except my mic would be right. It's kind of like here. And it hangs off the edge, so it's kind of like that. But yeah, I don't know, like again, these don't do anything, but it's just an aesthetic. And again, if you're doing a machinima or something, that's kind of handy. I also have some headphones just here laying around. They come in some colors as well, which is really cool. We also have some PC towers, which are right here. This is the basic one, and it comes in a couple of colors here. Again, aesthetic purposes. And then we have the what? Insufficient funds. Mother load this baby up so that I can show you guys everything. And then we have a more powerful looking PC. I do wish that these were able to kind of like turn on and work in a sense. I know it's kind of like unrealistic for the creator of these objects, but it just would be so cool, right? If you could do that. I also got some bath rugs, bathroom rugs, I guess you could say. I love this one. I like the texture. I do feel like it looks kind of like alpha-ish as far as the Sims game is concerned. It's a little bit too realistic looking, which isn't a bad thing at all. It's just that, you know, I'm so used to like just maxis match, just, you know, looking like distorted pixels, that it just looks a little too detailed for me. And then we also have the toilet carpet as well, or rug. I don't know why my words aren't coming out right today. Ew. There we go. Now I have everything kind of like set up. Let's make it orange because it is fall, 'tis the season. Ooh, that's kind of loud. I don't really like that. ooh, I like that though. That's cute. So yeah, you can kind of do that. I know you guys are going to think this is so random, but I also have bath towels. Obviously, I would not put my bath towels on the floor, but just to show you the different colors, we already have like a set of bath towels in game, but they don't come in a lot of colors. And let's be real, we don't all have like pink and white towels. We have different color towels, or at least I do. I have like a bunch of different color towels. Then I have this robe, and you know, we already have this in game as well, but it doesn't hurt to add another because this one comes in more colors. So yeah, I just feel like it's really cute for your Sims aesthetic, just to, you know, make it more personalized. Another thing that's really cool is this candle. Okay, I think it's the coolest thing ever. It's actually a mood changing candle as well too. So I'm gonna place it right here. And as you can see, it's lit. So it comes in like a decor option, and then it also comes in an option where it's going to be able to change your Sims mood, kind of like how the incense work in the Sims game. So this one is called Sea Salt and Cotton, and it'll give you a depressing decor, you know, aura. So your Sim might feel sad. This one's ginger and tobacco. This will be kind of stressful. This one, the basil mint, the original, is going to give you just a happy, regular feeling, kind of stationary. Let's place the romantic one down, right? Of course, it works like any other candle or any other light. So, you know, obviously it's lit. And then if we go here to enable emotional aura, we come over here, let's go inside, let's see if she'll actually turn romantic. Enough with the welcome wagon, we're good. We don't need friends, we have build CC, we don't need y'all. But yeah, so I wonder if you like, yeah, see, there we go. I was like, wait, I don't remember having to click anything. Yeah, so she instantly becomes flirty, she's a little romantic, she's got the candle blowing, and maybe she might ask Gavin to step inside. No, I'm kidding. We can obviously like extinguish this candle and then it'll go out. So if you don't want to feel frisky for 48 hours, then you don't have to. So that's kind of like how it works. If you go to the design tool and you try to switch the colors and scents from there, the script will fail because it needs to be purchased through build and buy mode that way, so that it knows that, you know, you want it to change your mood to whatever mood. So you would choose it prior to. I love this one, roasted coffee and cinnamon. It's going to give you the focused feeling. Enable it. Boom, she's focused. If you don't enable the emotional aura, then your Sim won't be changing emotions. So it's kind of cool, even just for aesthetic purposes. Next thing I want to show you is, who is this in my house? But I got this little candy bucket thing. I thought it was really cute. I feel like the game needs more of it, but it's a spooky season, so I couldn't resist. I was like, oh my goodness, I love it. Another thing I'm super duper stoked about finding is this tree lamp. I love it. I feel like we don't have enough like neutral, regular just tree lamps in the game. We have that one that has the funky colors, but look at this, like, what? I love that. I love that it has like the darker tones of the pink and then the light with it, as opposed to like blue, red, and yellow. Like, I just, that tree lamp, do you guys know which tree lamp I'm talking about in the game? It's just so confusing, and sometimes you just want a good regular old tree lamp. And then I have this little mini speaker, which, you know, again, for my gamers or people that want to kind of make it look like you have a little recording setup. Boom, there you go, a little mini speaker. I just threw it in there to see what it would look like, and it does work. It is a functional. Woohoo! Okay. Look at that. Our speakers work. Yes. Don't mind this stuff. This is actually like food that came with a mod. it was like toddler food or whatever. This isn't part of what I had to show you. I actually didn't get to mess around with that mod yet, so I don't want to like show it off to you and like something be wrong with it or something, so I don't know. And then the last thing I want to show you all is this cute little bassinet override. It's going to override the bassinet that we got in game, so you won't see that anymore. And when your baby appears, whether you have it at the hospital or at home, it will automatically be replaced with this really cute bassinet. I love it. I feel like it's so fitting. Now, you cannot change the color on this. The only thing you can change is like the color of the pillows and the blanket. But the actual framing of the bassinet, you have to download either the pine, there's two more wood options. But yeah, so I have the other two options backed up in another folder, so I can just interchange them however I please. It kind of just works the same as like a cast background, if you guys you know, download those. You can only have one in at a time. But I love that you can change the color of the blankets. So I personally love the pine swatch because I just think it's really cute and dainty looking. But yeah, so, you know, your little one would just be right here. And it's just so, it's so cute. So these are just a couple of things, again, that I feel like could, like, totally sprucing up your Sims, like, environment, you know, make it feel more personal. So I'm really glad I got to show you guys these things today. I'm kind of like venturing out. I know a lot of you are like, ooh, gross, Build CC. I'm like the same way, but I used to use a lot of it, like when I started, when I first got my gaming PC, and I kind of like backed off a little. But some of these items I just really like as far as like storytelling and just aesthetic purposes. So if you enjoyed them, please let me know. I will have everything linked down below. Look at me, Dr. Seuss. Dr. Seuss is in the building. Anyway, I love you guys so much. If you enjoyed this, please do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Just keep simming. Always, always stay wavy. And I will see you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Alrighty, peace out.